Hello everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to give you a quick walkthrough of Cubase. I'm going to show you all the basic functions that you need to know so that you can find your way around it and start being creative with it. Let's get started. The first thing that will greet you once you launch Cubase is the Steinberg Hub. Right here, you can do quite a few things, so it's a great starting point when you want to start creating a new project or even just learn a few things about Cubase and get some inspiration. As you can see, we have the news section right here, but we also have the project section right here. So here you can either select to create an empty project, or you can select from a wide range of presets for mastering, for production, scoring, and recording. And right here, you also have your most recent projects. I'm going to start with an empty project in this example, so I can show you how you can start creating your project from scratch. All I need to do is hit on empty, and then I have two options. I can either choose the default location for my projects, and I can just type in the name of my project here. This will create a new folder, and everything that you're going to record, audio, MIDI, are going to be in this specific folder. So this helps you keep things organized. Or you can prompt for project location, and if I do this, I can select a project that I choose, or I can create a new project myself. Now, in this case, I'm going to use the default location, and I'm going to click Create Empty. And there we are. Now we have a brand new, fresh Cubase project, and we can start creating our music. Now, very quickly, I want to show you how you can navigate Cubase very easily, because it's very nicely laid out and it all makes sense. In this main area, we have our project window. This is where all our tracks and our audio events, our MIDI events are going to end up into. Then we have the inspector, which is on the left side. Another very important part in Cubase is this lower bar right here. Here is where you can find your transport controls, your locator positions, your record modes, your tempo, time signatures, metronome on and off, pre-count, and the metronome setup. Right here on the right zone, we have quite a few interesting things. We have our VSTIs, so here's where our instruments are going to end up. We have our media bay, very important if you want to load instruments. We have our effects, loops and samples, presets, our user presets, and our file browser, and the favorites that we can set up ourselves. Then we have the control room and the meter section. Before I move on to the rest of the interface, let's actually load an instrument and let's start making some sound, right? So there are quite a few ways to create an instrument in Cubase. First, we can use this plus icon right here and click on Add Track. And as you can see here, we have quite a few options. We can create an audio track. This is when you can start recording audio, like a microphone, a guitar, and so on and so forth. Then we have the instrument tracks, which are going to be software instruments. Then we have a sampler track. I'm going to show you this a little bit later. MIDI tracks, and quite a few other options. In this case, I'm going to select instrument track, and I'm going to load one of the included synths, Retrolog. I can name the track as well. Let's call it Synth. I can hit Add Track. And there we go. Now I have Retrolog right here, and I can immediately start playing with it. Now, if I want to load a preset, I can do this very easily by just clicking here and selecting one of the presets. Now that we've created a channel, I can show you the left zone, which lives right here. Now, this includes the inspector and the visibility tabs. Now, the visibility tabs allow us to hide a channel if we want to clean up our project, and the inspector gives us pretty much all the necessary controls for any given channel. For example, we have the volume, panning, track delay, the inputs and outputs, track versions, the EQ, audio inserts, audio sends, and the quick controls. Now, you can completely customize the inspector. If you don't want to see all these things, all you need to do is just right click and you can untick any of these options. I personally like to keep everything activated. Arming a channel in Cubase is very easy. You can just hit record enable. And immediately, if you have an instrument channel, you can start playing on your MIDI keyboard. And if you have an audio channel, you can just start recording. Let me show you a very quick example. I'm going to create an audio channel this time. I'm going to select input 1 on my interface. I'm going to select my configuration and call it mic. And when you create an audio channel, right here you can select your inputs, your outputs, and you can record and enable the channel like this and monitor by hitting this button here. And this way you can start recording audio. It works exactly the same way with instrument channels. If I hit record and I have the record enable button activated, I can just... record MIDI notes. Now, if you want to see those MIDI notes, you just double click on the MIDI event and you can jump into the key editor straight away. The next thing I want to show you is the lower zone. And the lower zone is very interesting because it can show you a multitude of information very, very quickly. First of all, we have the mix console, which I'm going to talk about a little bit later as well. This is where we can see our channels. We can change the volume. We can change the panning right here. And we can start adding insert effects and send effects. For example, let's say I want to add a reverb to my synth here. I can go here to my inserts, type reverb, and now I can see a collection of all my reverbs that I have installed. In this case, I'm going to click on Revelation. And this is just one of the ways that you can add effects in Cubase, by the way. Now, next we have the editor tab, and here we can have the key editor, we can have the drum editor, and we can also have the score editor. Next, we have the sampler control. I'm going to show you this in a second. The core pads, we can trigger entire chords from this page. And next we have the MIDI remote. This is where you can start setting up your controllers to work in synergy with Cubase. The lower zone is resizable, which means that if you want a little bit more room so that you can do your editing, for example, in the key editor, as I have right here, maybe I want to move some notes around. Or I want to quantize my notes. This is very easily done in Cubase. You just press Q. The great thing with the lower zone is that it adapts to what you have selected in your project window. For example, right here, I have a MIDI part selected, and you can see that we are here in the key editor. But once I select an audio part, you can see that immediately the editor turns into the sample editor, which means right here, I can start editing my audio, I can start creating fades, do gain changes, start warping the audio. Reverse it, create silences, and of course apply plugins, the included plugins in Cubase or third-party plugins. The sample editor and the key editor can be opened with their own dedicated windows. Now, if you want to drop a sample in Cubase, it's very easy. This you do right here in the right zone with the media tab. We can also drag and drop instruments, and this is an alternative way in addition to the add track plus button right here. But we can also add loops and samples. So for example, if I want to, I can start searching for a drum loop, and right here, I'm going to have all the drum loops that I have in my system. Or I can go into any of the libraries, select a loop, and either drag and drop it into the project or just double click. Now, if I want to create a playable instrument using samples, I can do this very easily. All I need to do is go to my lower zone, and here we're going to use the sampler control. So I'm going to drop a sample into the sampler control window. For example, this one sounds good. Let's drag it in. And if I want, I can process the sample, of course. I can add a filter. Whoa. warp it, slice it, change the pitch, create glides. The sampler track is a really creative tool in Cubase. And speaking of creativity, I've already shown you Retrolog, but I also want to show you another instrument that's included in Cubase, and this is Patchop. Patchop is a beautiful granular synthesizer. It can create some really amazing textures, pads, leads, and pretty much everything in between. Now, if you want to create drums, I would totally recommend you check out the included Groove Agent SE. This is a really powerful drum instrument in Cubase. You can create electronic drum kits, you can also load acoustic drum kits, and you can load your own samples onto the pads right here. If you want to load presets in Groove Agent SE, you just click on this icon right here, and then you can load any of the included presets. And another very cool thing with Groove Agent SE is that it already includes patterns inside. So you can actually click on any one of these pads, and you already have a full arrangement for your drums. And if you want, you can drop this as a MIDI part into your Cubase project. Super neat. Now, another thing that I want to show you is the mix console window. This is very useful and very advanced, especially if you're planning to do any serious mixing in Cubase. If you want to open the mix console window, the default shortcut is F3 on your keyboard. Otherwise, you can bring it on by clicking this icon right here. Now, if for some reason you don't see these icons right here, you can just right-click and enable them by ticking the Media and Mix Console Windows option. And as you can see, you can customize this top row of buttons to your needs. So here we are in the console window, and as you can see, we have a very nice view of our faders, our panning, solo and mute controls, listen controls, edit channel controls. So this allows us to open the settings for our channel. And here we can see our EQ, our inserts, our sends, and also the channel strip, which we can also find right here. Inserts, EQ, channel strip, and send effects. And the mix console is completely customizable. So you can choose if you're going to have all channel types, or maybe you want to remove the input channels, remove the output channels. You can also select which racks you're going to have visible. The mix console in Cubase is a mixing powerhouse. Now, once you've created your project and you want to share it with the world, it's very likely that you will want to export a WAV or MP3 file. The first thing you have to do is set up your markers, which are located at the top of the project window, and then export audio mixdown. And here is where you can select which channels you want to export as an audio file. The most common thing, of course, is you would want to export the stereo out. So you select single channel, stereo out, you select the name of your song, the file type, sample rate, bit depth, and then you just hit export audio. So there you go, this was a brief overview of the main functions in Cubase. I hope you found this video useful, and if you want to learn more about these amazing features that we have in Cubase, make sure you check the other videos in this channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.